I've fought in 3 campaigns, in 7 pitched battles, in countless raids and skirmishes and desperate defenses and bloody actions of every kind. I've fought in the driving snow, the blasting wind, the middle of the night. I've been fighting all my life, one enemy or another, one friend or another. I've known little else. I've seen men killed for a word, for a look, for nothing at all. A woman tried to stab me once for killing her husband, and I threw her down a well. And that's far from the worst of it. Life used to be as cheap as dirt to me, cheaper. I fought 10 single combats, and I won them all. But I fought on the wrong side, and for all the wrong reasons. I've been ruthless, brutal, and a coward. I've stabbed men in the back, burned them, drowned them, crushed them with rocks, killed them asleep, unarmed or running away. I've run away myself more than once. I've pissed myself with fear. I've begged for my life. I've been wounded often and badly, and screamed and cried like a baby whose mother took her tit away. I've no doubt the world would be a better place if I'd been killed years ago. But I haven't been, and I don't know why. There are few men with more blood on their hands than me. None that I know of. The Bloody Nine, they call me, my enemies. And there's a lot of them. Always more enemies and fewer friends. Blood gets you nothing but more blood. It follows me now always like my shadow. And like my shadow, I can never be free of it. I should never be free of it. I've earned it. I've deserved it. I've sought it out. Such is my punishment. All things come to an end. He couldn't lift the old sword anymore. There was no strength left, nothing. The room was growing blurry. All things come to an end, but some only lie still, forgotten. There was a cold feeling in Logan's stomach, a feeling he hadn't felt for a long time. "No," he whispered. "I'm free of you." But it was too late. Too late. There was blood on him, but that was good. There was always blood, but he was kneeling, and that was wrong. The Bloody Nine kneels to no man. Die! Logan might have pitied him. But Logan was far away, and the Bloody Nine had no more pity in him than the winter, less even. He stabbed and cut and cut and smiled, and the screams bubbled and died. Quiet now. They send such as you to fight me? A fucking insult! More. More! He bellowed, and he laughed, and the walls laughed, and the corpses laughed with him. Where's the rest of you? Come, he whispered. They all were welcome. Armed or not, their death was a thing already decided. It was written into the cavern in lines of fire and lines of shadow. Now he would write it in lines of blood.
Lost, so see. Done, McGlass! capture Zone C.
In order, sir!
Fear and pain were fuel on the fire, and the flames surged high and higher yet. The world burned, and at its center, the Bloody Nine burned hottest of all. They were animals, and less than animals. Their weapons stabbed and cut at him, but the Bloody Nine was made of fire and darkness, and he drifted and slithered between their crude blows, around their fumbling spears, under and over their worthless screams and their useless fury. Easier to stab the flickering flame, easier to cut the shifting shadows. Their weakness was an insult to his strength. Nathan be a reasonable man? Perhaps he used to be. But Nine Fingers is blood drunk, murder proud. Every day he is less your friend, less to be trusted, less a man at all, and more an animal. Every day he is less Logan and more the Bloody Nine. Last week he killed a whole pen full of sheep. Did you know that? Because their bleating bothered him, he said. He killed them with his hands, one by one, so calmly, the others didn't even stir. And when the sheepdog barked, he crushed her head, and they found him sound asleep and snoring among the corpses. He is made of death, and he brings death wherever he goes. He scares me. Easier to stop the White Flow than to stop the Bloody Nine.